Ho, ho, ho. Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jelen. Well, it's the day after Christmas, and hopefully you had a great holiday. Maybe you got some cool gifts like an iPod Touch, or maybe an Xbox 360, maybe a new PC. Watch out for that new PC. Someone may have slipped and gotten you the one with Vista and Office 2007. Now, if you have Vista and Office 2007, of course, I want to point out that I have some great books. Excel 2007 Miracles Made Easy will get you up that learning curve through Excel 2007. And for the rest of the year at the Mr. Excel store, you can use this coupon code TECHME, T-E-C-H-M-E, for 20% off any of our Excel 2007 books, CDs, DVDs, a whole bit there. Well, hey, today we have a question from Paul. Paul wrote in from Southern Ontario. Says, hey, I'm creating a timesheet. We need a drop-down list with all of the week ending dates, and our weeks happen to end on Sunday. So let's take a look at a couple of different functions here. The today function is a simple little function that will return today's date. And what I want to do then is use the weekday function, equal weekday of today, basically. Now, normally, if we would just use this function, it would say that Sunday is 1 and Saturday is 7. But if we put a comma 2 at the end, then we'll see that basically they number Monday as 1. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to create a nice little list out here to the side. It says equal today minus the weekday of today, comma 2, and that will return the most recent Sunday. And then from there, I'm going to add 7 in case someone is filling out their timesheets in advance, or we'll go back a few weeks, so equal this minus 7 to give us the last few weeks. And this list now basically will become the source for my data validation dropdown. So somewhere where they're going to enter the date, we'll use data validation. Instead of allowing any value, we want to allow a list and specify that our list is out here in E1 through E7. Now what happens is this tiny little list will give us all of the weeks and it will be updated. So if we come in 3 months from now, that list will have a list of the recent weeks, the current week, and a few future weeks, basically allowing anyone to fill out any list they would ever need. So thanks to Paul for sending in that great question, and thanks to you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.